So the complexity is actually the opportunity for a sustainable pathway forward.
Because it gives you the space to move around.
Yeah.
It gives you the space to look for co-benefits. It gives you the space to look for stakeholders, alliances.
And no one can escape. The moment if you take just the pie from the chart, then you're lost. With the interventions you create, those are opportunities to be scaled up. You need these type of innovations that inspire, bring investors and policymakers and industry as well as NGOs and individuals to the table. Say, there's something we can do. What we must do is also something we have to show that we can do.
So the entry point for financing is difficult. It can be national, it can be local, but the geographical scale of where the problems and the solutions are may not be the same as the geographical scale of the decision making on the one hand and of the receiving entity for financing on the other. These are challenges that we've been facing for a very long time. And I'm thinking of a strange example maybe, but we talk about co-benefits a lot, right? Also in the climate space. The fact that, for instance, we have in with a water investment also climate adaptation benefits. This sometimes, the fact that it is also, that it's not only, has played against the selection of water projects in some multilateral financial institutions that were striving to augment their climate finance in terms of the climate finance volumes, because other projects would deliver higher percentages of climate finance compared to the water projects. These internal strange logics.
So when it comes to water, water governance and water management are mainly addressed when SDG 6 is being highlighted. Mm-hmm. But we have to bear in mind that there are water-related targets that exist in many of the other SDGs. And we need to definitely take more fully into account the water, water's connections to our societal, environmental, and economic needs. Mm-hmm. I'll finish with two images.
Yep.
The first one is what we normally see when we talk about SDGs. It's this kind of just, a list of the various SDGs that we have. Mm-hmm. And we see them, next to each other, and this doesn't necessarily convey any sense that they are linked to one another. So what I would prefer is a second image that you see on the screen. This is something that is called the wedding cake of the SDGs. This shows that at the foundation of this wedding cake, we have the SDG 6, 13, 14, and 15, the environmental SDGs that support the societal and economic goals. And this is really the way to look at how we transform the implementation of the various global agendas. We have all of the frameworks we need, and we have brilliant tools like the River Basin Delta tool to connect to the global agendas and give them life. But now what we have to do is to strive to implement the global agendas in an integrated manner.
The COVID-19 crisis presents an opportunity to build back better and to try to include those challenges in river basin and delta management that we have discussed today in the future planning and growth of the countries around the world. As you are correctly asking in the question, to get us to work in a better direction will require sustained, coordinated approaches in country. Mm-hmm. And how we do this is the biggest challenge. And a final point on opportunities is to link water and sanitation issues in large urban areas, particularly those in delta areas, in hotspots, with a circular economy approach and dealing with unplanned settlements, particularly in deltas, and achieving SDG 6 and bringing benefits from others.
It is also about continuity, consistency, and commitment.
Yeah.
And what we see around the world is that we really like to hop around from pilot to pilot. So we do a project in this river basin and then a project there. But these type of approaches, system-based approaches, are rigorously, fundamentally based on consistency, commitment, and continuity. And if we can get that with the stakeholders all involved, then there is an opportunity with such a tool, this river basin tool, that helps us assess risk, helps us assess opportunities, and helps accommodate a process of collaboration towards identifying those interventions that really make a difference.